जंगल जंगल फिर बात चली।
ऑल इंडिया रेडियो प्रेजेंट्स फैबुलस फेबल्स ऑफ इंडिया, स्ट्रिक्टली फॉर किड्स एंड द यंग एट हार्ट।
जंगल जंगल फिर बात चली। इस प्रोग्राम में आज बारी है अ टेल ऑफ टू फिश एंड अ फ्रॉग की, और सुना रहे हैं वी शिव कुमार।
There was a lovely lake in a village inhabited by fishermen. The lake was blue-green and had a large number of creatures: fish, turtles, crabs, and frogs. The cranes and herons used to spend most of their time diving into the still water of the lake to look for food. In this very lake lived three friends: two fish and a frog. The first fish was called Sahasrabuddhi, meaning one who was 1,000 times smarter and wiser than the others. Sahasrabuddhi was fat with shiny gills and scales and a long tail. The second fish was named Shatabuddhi, meaning one who was 100 times wiser than the others. He was also big, with pink scales and a shorter tail. The two of them were very good friends, and both had a frog called Ekabuddhi as their common friend. Ekabuddhi was not considered very smart. The three of them used to live with their families in the lake. They were very happy. They had lots to eat, and every evening they would assemble near the edge of the lake next to the well used by the villagers. They used to talk about everything under the sun till it was dark. One day, the three of them were at their usual spot when they heard people talking. They were fishermen returning to the village with nets and baskets filled with fish. Ekabuddhi could understand human language, having lived in the village pond some time ago. He heard one of the fishermen say, "Look, look, the fish in the lake seem to have grown big. Let us come to the lake tomorrow instead of going all the way to the ocean to catch fish." Ekabuddhi was very worried, as he could foresee danger. He jumped onto the nearby rock and cried, "Krom, krom, krom, krom." Sahasrabuddhi and Shatabuddhi had also heard the fishermen. "What is it, Ekabuddhi?" asked Sahasrabuddhi. "I am scared," said Ekabuddhi. "What if they catch me and my family? Oh, friends, let's go away from here to the pond or the well. Didn't you hear? They will come here tomorrow. We may get caught." "Oh, is that why you are looking worried?" laughed Sahasrabuddhi. "You see what these people say, they never do. They may not come here at all. Even if they do, they will never be able to catch me. Look, I am a swift swimmer and can dodge their nets easily," said Sahasrabuddhi. "Yes, yes, you are right, Sahasrabuddhi. We have been living here without any problem. We know so many tricks to survive. We are smart, aren't we? Why should we go away to any other pond?" "We are not leaving," said Shatabuddhi. Ekabuddhi was dejected. He said, "Friends, I may not be so smart, but one thing I can see is danger. If you both are staying, I cannot force you to come with me, but I am leaving tonight." Saying this, Ekabuddhi swam away. Both Sahasrabuddhi and Shatabuddhi waved their tail fins in irritation and went on with their lives. The very next morning, as soon as the sun's first rays fell on the lake, the fishermen appeared with their nets and baskets. They cast their nets all over the lake. They caught a lot of fish, frogs, and crabs. As soon as the nets were cast, Sahasrabuddhi and Shatabuddhi tried their best to wriggle out. They dodged and swam fast to avoid the nets, but none of their tricks worked. Both were caught. Being large and bulky, the fishermen strung them up and hung them from their shoulders. Meanwhile, the frog Ekabuddhi had found himself and family a well for shelter. He happened to come to the surface hearing the noise and saw the fishermen taking away Shatabuddhi and Sahasrabuddhi. "Alas," he said to his wife, "I had warned them. They both were very wise, but wisdom is of no use if you cannot use common sense. That's why I am here with you, swimming happily, safe with my family, though I am just Ekabuddhi, a normal frog." His wife smiled happily.
A Tale of Two Fish and a Frog. सुना रहे थे वी शिवकुमार. इस कहानी से आपको क्या प्रेरणा मिली? मिली भी या नहीं? मुझे क्या प्रेरणा मिली वो मैं जरूर शेयर करूंगी आपके साथ, लेकिन उससे पहले आपको बता दूं कि आपके व्यूज भी बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट हैं. आप अपने व्यूज शेयर करना फेसबुक के पेज आकाशवाणी फीचर्स पर. और मैं बताऊं मुझे प्रेरणा मिली कि सिर्फ और सिर्फ तेज बुद्धि ही काफी नहीं है. आप चाहे कितने ही बुद्धिमान क्यों ना हो, सहस्र बुद्धि हो या शत बुद्धि, समय पर विवेक और बुद्धि का इस्तेमाल नहीं किया गया तो फिर आप भी ऐसी ही मुसीबतों के शिकार हो सकते हैं. आपने देखा, मेंढक खतरे की पहली ही घंटी पर सचेत होकर अपने परिवार को बचाने के लिए जरूरी कदम उठाया. जी हाँ, समय रहते ही कदम उठाना जरूरी होता है. तो आप YouTube आकाशवाणी AIR पर जाकर इन कहानियों को दोबारा तिबारा जितनी बार सुनना चाहो सुन सकते हो. लेकिन हमसे जरूर कनेक्टेड रहना और अपना बहुत सारा ख्याल रखना. बाय.
A presentation of the Central English and Hindi Features Units for our External Services Division. This broadcast came to you from the Delhi Station, a volunteer radio.
जंगल जंगल फिर बात चली.
बंदर की पूछ ने मारा टाइगर को, टाइगर की मुझे चुभ गई गीदर को. नहीं, मुझे कुछ भी नहीं हुआ. वो मैं रोज ऑल इंडिया रेडियो पर जंगल जंगल फिर बात चली सुनती हूँ ना, तो ये सारे प्यारे प्यारे एनिमल्स मेरे फ्रेंड्स बन गए हैं. कल तो एक बेबी एलिफेंट मेरी ड्रीम में आ गया. उसकी पीठ पर एक कछुआ बैठा हुआ था ढेर सारे बलून्स के साथ. फिर क्या हुआ, मेरे ना दादा दादी नहीं हैं. मम्मा कहती हैं वो वहाँ दूर स्टार्स में रहते हैं. थैंक यू आकाशवाणी इन मीठी मीठी कहानियों के लिए. तानुं 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 तानुं
जंगल जंगल फिर बात चली.